Hi everyone, today I'm going to be showing you how to make Harry Potter wands the easy way. Now when you're making a wand, there are three aspects to making a wand. The first one is to have a proper base. The second is to have proper designing, like a hand. So I'm going to start with the most crucial and the basic part of making a wand, that is the base. Now there are many ways to make a base and I'm going to start with the first method. Now in this what we do is, I've just taken a twig branch which I've taken from a tree. And I'm just going to scrape out the bark and make it more smooth like this, and you can finished product like this. And I've just used a knife, like a kitchen knife is also fine, and then I've used sandpaper to give it a smooth look. Now this is too long, so I would want to cut it till here or something to give it a proper look. And now one other method which you can use with wood itself is taking a wood piece and carving a wand out of that. So I have finished cutting it and I have sandpapered this part also to make it smooth, and I have tapered it a little more and you've got a wand base. So this is the first way how to make a wand base. Now another way to make a wand base is, instead of using wood and twig and scraping and all that stuff, you can just use a wooden brush which you can get like this in the store, and all you need to do is chop off this part of the brush and you will have to sandpaper this part to take out the polish and varnish, so you can do it again, and then you get a ready-made wand base like that. But now, so now I have chopped off the brush part and I have sandpapered it to get the look. Now I realized that it is very small for me and I want it to be a little longer. So what you can do is you can either take newspapers, any magazine wrapper papers, and roll it up to form a line together with tape. Now the point is that we are going to be adding clay to make a handle over it, so it's not going to be noticeable. It can be any width, it doesn't matter actually. So I had to chop off the wood of in the other wand base, so I'm just going to use that, and I'm going to be sticking it together with tape. Right. So you have got your wand base ready and you have taped it up. So it is very good for when you're holding parties and you want to make wands. If it's a Harry Potter themed party, you can make these paper wands, and these are disposable also if you want, otherwise you can keep them. And these are very easy methods. Now in this, you need to first roll the paper and make sure you roll it where one side you keep it tighter than the other side to get a tapering result. Now before you start, you put it, apply a little glue over here so that, you know, it does not open up from the inside, and then you start rolling. Okay, so I don't want it to be thicker than this, so I'm just going to stop here, and the crucial part here is to apply glue so that it does not open up later on. You can cut off the rest. So once you've got your wand ready, now you're going to apply glue over the whole thing to make sure that these things do not open up once you've painted it, and to make it, give it a more sturdy effect as well. Okay, so now it's ready and dried up with the coating done. So I have showed you three ways to make a wand base: out of a wood branch, from a wooden paintbrush, and from paper. This is part one of how to make the base. Now we're going to start with how to design the wands. Now for this, we have got many options. Like in this wand, you can just leave it like that if you want, because it's already got a good design. But if you really want to design it, then you can use clay. And I've got this modeling clay, which is this terracotta modeling clay. Okay. And this is an air drying clay which dries in 24 hours. So I'm going to use this clay for one, to fill up the paper wand because it's empty and hollow inside, and to give it weight, and for this to give it a proper handle. Now another way to do it is, if you want, you can just use clay and cover the whole wand in clay. Just if you don't want to paint it, for that you need to use colored clay. And you can just cover the whole wand in clay and it'll dry and you get a proper wand. But otherwise, I would suggest that you just make the handles or the other designs which you need out of clay, so so that you can paint it in your own design later. This is the terracotta modeling clay which I've used, and it's better to first work it out and knead it a little bit so it's more pliable and softer to use. It's easier to use. Okay, and now all you need to do is start by first wrapping the whole part with it, and once you start doing that, then all you need to do is shape it out. Okay, so this is dried up now, and so I'm going to fill it up with clay so that you get the weight and it's filled up and steady. Now this clay is air hardening clay, so in case if it starts drying, just take a little bit of water, it becomes soft again. Okay, and always have toothpicks with you, because when you're making the hand, when you're making the handle or any design, it's very good, like for carving, for putting, carving it out or putting any designs on the clay, it's good to have toothpicks. So now what we're going to do is make small rolls like this and fill the whole thing up till it is filled with, comes till here, like you always leave a little bit of gap, like around like half a centimeter gap you leave inside. Okay, so then at the end, when we can when it's open like that, there's no place to close it up, you can either take the clay and cover it up totally, or you can take glue and fill it up till the end. So when the glue, so now I filled it up with clay, and I have just put clay around the corners and molded it up as well. And now so this is the one which I made from the brush, and I've made the basic model, and all I have to do is just let it dry. But make sure you don't leave it to dry under the fan or something, because then it starts cracking when it dries up, and that's very bad because you always can't repair the cracks. So the best thing to do is to put it under running water for like 1 minute or for like 30 seconds, and then put it in a plastic bag and cover it, and then or a damp cloth, and then leave it overnight, so it'll dry on its own pace and it won't crack much. So that way you can prevent cracks. Okay, so now I've designed all the wands, and the clay has dried right now. So I've got four different designs, as you can see. And now, since the second part is over, now we're going to start the painting process. Now for painting, either you can just put one whole coat, like you can make the whole wand black and just have dabs of gold or something in between. Or you can add colors and mix it and shade it up, and it's up to you actually. You can paint it however you wish. Now these are basic colors which are used, which look good on wands. And you should always remember to use only acrylic paints. They can be the tubes or bottles. And these are the best paints suitable for painting wands. But do not use poster paints. That is one thing you always have to keep in mind. Now you can use different colors, like this black, this gold, bronze, brown, the different shades of brown, ivory if you want, like Lord Voldemort is ivory. So depending on your choice, you can paint them. After painting, if you want, there's this fixative which comes for acrylic paints, and if you apply that over the wand, it will help it, it will not smudge then, so it will be more long lasting, the paint will be more long lasting if you apply the fixative. Okay, so here are the end products. I made four different types of wands. And I have made the box also by myself, so if you want to see how to make the Ollivander's box, you can click on the link below in the description and you can see how to make the box as well. There you have it, how to make wands in three different ways.